Assalamu alaikum to all my dear students. Hope you all are fine. We are passing hard time for pandemic attack of coronavirus. We locked at home, but don't waste your time. Make a routine and continue your study regularly. Today I am here to discuss with you about the bones of superior extremity. This class is mainly for first year MBBS student MMC 9 batch, but second year students you can also memorize with me. Superior extremity or upper limb is made up of four parts: shoulder, arm or brachium, forearm and hand. The shoulder region includes the pectoral or breast region on the front of the chest, the axilla or armpit, and the scapular region on the back, comprising parts around the scapula. The bones of shoulder girdle are the clavicle and the scapula. This is the shoulder girdle containing bones clavicle and scapula. The arm extends from the shoulder to the elbow. The bones of the arm is humerus. Its upper end meets with the glenoid cavity of scapula and forms the shoulder joint. The forearm extends from the elbow to the wrist. The bones of the forearm are the radius laterally and ulna medially. At their upper end, they meet the lower end of the humerus and form the elbow joint. Their lower end meets at the carpal bone to form the wrist joint. The radius and ulna meet each other at the radial ulnar joint. The hand include the wrist supported by eight carpal bone arranged in two row, the hand proper or metacarpus supported by five metacarpal bones and five digit, thumb and four fingers. Each finger is supported by three phalanges, 1, 2, 3. But thumb has only two phalanges. Total phalanges are 14 in number. Humerus. Anatomical point of humerus is, this is the head. Head directed upwards, medially and slightly backwards. Bicipital group. Group between two tubercle, greater tubercle and lesser tubercle. This is the intertubercular sulcus or group or bicipital group. It directed forwards. Olecranon fossa directed backwards. This is the anatomical points of the humerus. The parts of the humerus are, it is a long bone, typical long bone. It contains two end and shaft, upper end, lower end and intervening shaft. The features of the upper end presents head, neck, greater tubercle, lesser tubercle, intertubercular sulcus or bicipital group. The neck is divided into two. This is the anatomical neck and this is the surgical neck. The shaft presents three surfaces: anteromedial surface, anterolateral surface and posterior surface. This is the posterior surface. Three border. Medial border extend from medial margin of the head to the medial epicondyle. Lateral border extend from lateral margin of greater tubercle to the lateral epicondyle. And anteriorly, this is the anterior border. The surface lies between the anterior border and medial border. This is the anteromedial surface, and the surface lies between anterior border and lateral border. This is the anterolateral surface, and the surface lies between the medial and lateral border. This is the posterior surface. Posterior surface is divided by upper part and lower part, and there is presence of deltoid tuberosity. Lower end presents some features. There is lateral epicondyle, projected medial, prominent medial epicondyle, radial fossa, coronoid fossa, capitulum and trochlea. attachment of the humerus. The upper end of the humerus, there is presence of greater tubercle, lesser tubercle and intertubercular sulcus. Attachment on the greater tubercle, there are origin of insertion of three muscles from above down are supraspinatus, infraspinatus, teres minor. Greater tubercle, there is three muscle is inserted from above downwards, there is supraspinatus, infraspinatus and teres minor. Lesser tubercle, there is insertion of the subscapularis muscle, bicipital group. It presents lateral border, medial border and floor. Lateral border, there is insertion of the pectoralis major. Medial border, there is insertion of the teres major and floor, there is insertion of the latissimus dorsi. Shift of the humerus at the lower part of the anteromedial and anterolateral surface, the brachialis muscle is originated from here. On the posterior surface, in upper part, there is origin of the lateral head of triceps, and from the lower part, there is medial head of the triceps is originated. Lower end presents medial supracondylar line. From here, pronator teres is originated, and from the medial epicondyle, there is common origin of the flexor muscle. Lateral supracondylar line, there is origin of the brachioradialis. Below the brachioradialis, there is origin of the extensor carpi radialis longus, and below the extensor carpi radialis longus, there is anconeus is originated. And from the lateral epicondyle, there is common origin of the extensor muscle of the forearm. These are the attachment of the humerus. The picture shows the attachment of humerus. Nerve related with the humerus. Three nerves are directly related to the humerus. The axillary nerve are related at the posterior part of the surgical neck along with the posterior circumflex humeral artery. Radial nerve related with the radial groove along with the arteria profunda brachii, which is the largest branch of the brachial artery. Ulnar nerve passes behind the medial epicondyle. These three nerves are directly related with the humerus. Axillary nerve, radial nerve and ulnar nerve. Axillary nerve behind the surgical neck, radial nerve on the radial groove, ulnar nerve behind the medial epicondyle. Attachment of capsular ligament. At the upper end, the capsular ligament of shoulder joint is attached to the anatomical neck except on the medial side where the line of attachment dips down by about 2 cm to include a small area of the shaft within the joint cavity. The line is interrupted at the intertubercular sulcus to provide an aperture through which the tendon of long head of biceps leaves the joint cavity. This is the bicipital group. There is capsular attachment is deficient for passing of the long head of long tendon of the bicep brachii. Below, the capsule attached at the lower end of the humerus, above to the humerus along the upper margin of the coronoid and radial fossa, to the front of the medial and lateral epicondyles, below to the margin of the coronoid process of the ulna and to the annular ligament, which surrounds the head of the radius. Ossification. The humerus ossifies from one primary center and seven secondary centers. The primary centers appear in the middle of the diaphysis during the 8th week of development. The upper end ossifies from three secondary centers, one for the head, one for the greater tubercle, and one for the lesser tubercle. The lower end ossifies from four centers, one for the capitulum, ossification of the humerus. The humerus ossifies from one primary center and seven secondary centers. The primary center appears in the middle of the diaphysis during the 8th week of development. The upper end ossifies from three secondary centers, one for the head, one for the greater tubercle, and one for the lesser tubercle. The lower end ossifies from four centers, one for the capitulum, one for the lateral flange of trochlea, one for the medial flange of trochlea, and one for the lateral epicondyle. The center for the medial epicondyle appears during 4 to 6 years. Growing end. The growing end of humerus lies at the upper end. The nutrient foramen is always directed away from the growing end. The growing end direction, it lies opposite the direction of the nutrient foramen. So, upper end of the humerus is the growing end. Clinical anatomy. The common site of fracture is the surgical neck. There is injury to the axillary nerve. Behind the surgical neck, there is axillary nerve is related. If surgical neck is fractured, axillary nerve is injured and deltoid muscle is paralyzed. Abduction movement of the shoulder joint is not possible. Supracondylar fracture is common in young age. It is produced by fall on outstretched hand. The head of humerus commonly dislocates inferiorly. Joint produced by the humerus. The head of humerus articulate with the glenoid cavity of the scapula form the shoulder joint. It is a ball and socket type of synovial joint. According to axis, it is a multi-axial joint. This joint move around more than two axes, so it is a multi-axial joint. Movement produced by the shoulder joint. The muscle producing movements are flexion, clavicular head of pectoralis major, anterior fiber of deltoid, extension, posterior fiber of deltoid, teres major, abduction, 0 to 15 degree abduction caused by supraspinatus, 15 to 90 degree by middle fiber of deltoid, and above 90 degree by trapezius serratus anterior. Adduction, anterior and posterior fiber of deltoid, pectoralis major, teres major, latissimus dorsi, coracobrachialis, and long head of triceps. Medial rotation, anterior fiber of deltoid, pectoralis major, subscapularis, caused the medial rotation. Lateral rotation, caused by infraspinatus, teres minor, and posterior fiber of deltoid. The picture shows different movement of the shoulder joint. This is the extension, this is flexion, this is abduction away from the midline, and this is adduction, movement towards the midline. This is medial rotation and this is lateral rotation. This is circumduction. Shoulder joint is a weak joint because the laxity of the fibrous capsule and small and shallow glenoid cavity. The stability of shoulder joint is maintained by rotator cuff, coracoacromial arch, and glenoidal labrum. Rotator cuff. This is important question for written exam. Four short muscles around the joint, subscapularis, supraspinatus, infraspinatus, and teres minor blend with the fibrous capsule and form the rotator cuff or musculotendinous cuff. Function is it maintains the stability of the shoulder joint. The picture shows rotator cuff or musculotendinous cuff. Lower end of humerus articulate with the head of the radius and trochlear notch of the ulna form the elbow joint. Movement produced by this joint. This is the hinge variety of synovial joint and movement are produced. Muscle responsible for the movement, flexion, brachialis, bicep brachii and brachioradialis, extension, triceps and anconeus. This is the movement of the elbow joint. This is flexion and this is the extension. Carrying angle. When the elbow is fully extended, the forearm supinated, the arm and the forearm form an angle which is open on the lateral side. This is known as carrying angle. So that the ulnar border of the forearm does not come in close contact with the lateral surface of the thigh, and this facilitates to carry a heavy object grasped by the hand. The angulation is caused partly by the medial edge of the trochlea projecting below the lateral edge and partly by the obliquity of the superior articular surface of the coronoid process. The carrying angle disappears when the elbow is flexed and the forearm pronated. The picture shows the carrying angle. Clavicle. Anatomical points. The lateral end is flat and medial end is large, quadrilateral. This is the medial end of the clavicle and this is lateral end of the clavicle. Medial end is quadrilateral, large, and lateral end is flattened. This is medial or sternal end. This is lateral or flat acromial end. Anatomical point is the lateral end is flat and medial end is large, quadrilateral. The shaft is slightly curved so that its medial two-thirds is convex forwards, lateral one-third is concave directed forwards. The inferior surface is marked by subclavian groove. This is the subclavian groove which present on the inferior surface of medial two-thirds of the lateral part of medial two-thirds of the clavicle for the attachment of the subclavius muscle. Parts. It consists of two end, large medial end and flat acromial end. Medial two-thirds presents four surfaces. This is anterior surface, this is superior surface, this is posterior surface, and this is inferior surface. The lateral part of inferior surface is marked by subclavian groove. Lateral one-third presents two surfaces, superior surface and inferior surface. Two border, anterior border. This is the anterior border and this is the posterior border. Lateral one-third presents two surface and two border. An elevation on the lateral one-third of the clavicle is called conoid tubercle, and a line or ridge, this is called trapezoid line or trapezoid ridge. Two border, anterior border and posterior border. Anterior border is concave and posterior border is convex. Why clavicle is called modified long bone or peculiarities of the clavicle? It is the only long bone that lies horizontally. It is subcutaneous throughout. It is the first bone to start ossifying. It is the only long bone which ossify in membrane. It is the only long bone which has two primary ossification center. It has no medullary cavity. Attachment of the clavicle. Medial two-thirds. The anterior surface gives attachment. The clavicular head of the pectoralis major muscle originated from here. The superior surface. This part is rough due to origin of the sternocleidomastoid muscle. Superiorly, origin of the sternocleidomastoid muscle, and anterior surface gives origin of the clavicular head of the pectoralis major muscle. On posterior part, there is costoclavicular ligament is attached and sternohyoid muscle is originated from the medial part of the posterior surface of the clavicle. The lateral part of the medial two-thirds of inferior surface of clavicle, there is a subclavian groove which gives insertion of the attachment of the clavicle. The in medial lateral half of the medial two-thirds inferior surface, there is a subclavian groove which gives insertion of the subclavius muscle. The margin of the subclavian groove, there is attachment of the clavipectoral fascia. Lateral one-third, the anterior border, there is origin of the deltoid muscle, and posterior border gives insertion of the trapezius muscle. Conoid tubercle, there is attachment of the conoid part of the coracoclavicular ligament, and trapezoid line gives attachment of the trapezoid part of the coracoclavicular ligament. These are the attachment of the clavicle. Joint produced by the clavicle. The sternal end of the clavicle articulate with the clavicular notch of the sternum and forms the sternoclavicular joint, which is the saddle variety of synovial joint, and flattened acromial end of the scapula, which articulate with the lateral or acromial end of the clavicle, form the acromioclavicular joint, which is the plain variety of synovial joint. Clinical anatomy. The clavicle is commonly fractured by falling on the outstretched hand. The most common site of fracture is the junction between the two curvatures of the bone, which is the weakest point of the clavicle. The scapula. The scapula is a thin bone placed on the posterolateral aspect of the thoracic case. Anatomical point is the glenoid cavity. This is the glenoid cavity, which is directed forwards laterally. The coracoid process directed forwards, and the inferior angle directed downwards. These are the anatomical points of the scapula. Parts of scapula. Scapula presents two surfaces. This is costal surface or subscapular fossa. This is dorsal surface, which is divided into two parts by spine of the scapula, upper supraspinous fossa and lower infraspinous fossa. There are three border. This is thick lateral border, this is the superior border, and thin medial border. Three angle, superior angle, lateral angle, and inferior angle. The processes of scapula are coracoid process, acromion process, and spinous process. The attachment of the scapula are the costal surface or subscapular fossa, there is origin of the subscapularis muscle, and dorsal surface, supraspinous fossa, gives origin supraspinatus muscle, infraspinous fossa, there is gives origin of the infraspinatus muscle. Medial border. On the dorsal surface of the medial border, there is three muscles are inserted. Levator scapulae, rhomboideus minor at the level of the spine, and below the spine there is rhomboideus major, and inferior angle there is origin of the latissimus dorsi. At the costal surface of the medial border, on the costal surface there is insertion of the 8 digitation of serratus anterior muscle. The lateral end on the scapula, there is origin of the teres major. Between the fiber of the teres major, here circumflex scapular artery are passes. The glenoid cavity presents two tubercles. Upper tubercle is called supraglenoid tubercle, and lower tubercle is called infraglenoid tubercle. This is the coracoid process. At the tip of the coracoid process, there is origin of the short head of byssus brachii and coracobrachialis. Behind the origin of the biceps, there is insertion of the pectoralis minor muscle. From long head of From supraglenoid tubercle, there is origin of the long head of biceps, and from infraglenoid tubercle, there is origin of the long head of triceps. These are the attachment of the scapula. The picture shows origin and insertion of the muscles of the scapula and humerus. There is supraspinous muscle, infraspinous muscle, which are originated from the scapula and inserted into the greater tubercle of the humerus. Teres minor, which is originated from the dorsal surface of the lateral border of the scapula, and it inserted on the lower part of the greater tubercle of humerus. Latissimus dorsi, it originated from the inferior angle of the scapula, and it inserted on the floor of the bicipital group of humerus. The deltoid muscle originated from the lower lip of the spine of the scapula and anterior border of the lateral one-third of the clavicle, and it inserted on the deltoid tuberosity of the humerus. The upper lip, there is insertion of the trapezius muscle. The subscapularis muscle, which originated from the subscapular fossa of the scapula, and it inserted on the lesser tubercle of the humerus. The triceps, which originated from the infraglenoid tubercle, long head, and lateral head, originated from the upper part of the posterior surface of the humerus, and medial head from the lower part of the posterior surface of the humerus. These are the attachment on the scapula and humerus. Relation of the scapula. Superior border presents a notch. This is called suprascapular notch. It is converted into foramen by attachment of the transverse scapular ligament. Suprascapular nerve vessel passes through this foramen. The suprascapular artery passes above the ligament, and suprascapular nerve passes below the ligament. Joint produced by the scapula are: the glenoid cavity articulate with the head of humerus, forms the shoulder joint, and acromion process articulate with the acromial end of the clavicle, form the acromioclavicular joint. Shoulder joint is the ball and socket variety of synovial joint, and acromioclavicular joint is the plain variety of synovial joint. Clinical anatomy. If long thoracic nerve is injured, there is paralysis of the serratus anterior muscle, causes winging of scapula. The medial border of the scapula becomes prominent, and the arm cannot be abducted beyond 90 degree. The picture shows there is medial border is prominent. Winging of the this condition is called winging of scapula. In a developmental anomaly called scaphoid scapula, the medial border is concave. The radius. The radius is the lateral bone of the forearm. It is homologous with the tibia of the lower limb. Anatomical points. The upper end presents head, which is rounded and concave directed upwards. Radial tuberosity directed forwards. Styloid process lies at the lower end and directed posterolaterally. The dorsal tubercle lies at the lower end and directed backwards. Parts of the radius are: it is a typical long bone. It has three parts: upper end, this is the upper end shaped, and lower end. Upper end presents disc-shaped head, which is rounded neck and radial tuberosity. Shape presents three border and three surfaces. Anterior border extend from anterior margin of the radial tuberosity to the styloid process, and posterior border medial or interosseous border. surfaces. Anterior surface lies between the anterior surfaces of radius r. It presents three surfaces. Anterior surface lies between the anterior and interosseous border. Posterior surface lies between the posterior and interosseous border. Lateral surface lies between the anterior and posterior border. Lower end. Lower end is the widest part of the bone. It has five surfaces. Anterior surface is in the thick prominent ridge, forms the styloid process. The radial artery is palpated against this surface. Posterior surface present four group for extensor tendons. The dorsal tubercle lies lateral to an oblique group. Medial surface is occupied by the ulnar notch for the head of the ulna. Lateral surface prolong downwards to form the styloid process. Inferior surface bears a triangular area for the scaphoid bone and a medial quadrangular area for the lunate bone. This surface takes part in the formation of wrist joint. Attachment of the radius. Upper end presents radial tuberosity. It has rough posterior part and smooth anterior part. Rough posterior part here gives insertion of the biceps brachii muscle and smooth anterior part covered by bursa. The lateral surface, upper part of the lateral surface, there is insertion of supinator muscle. From medial part, pronator teres is inserted, and from lower part, the brachioradialis muscle is inserted. The anterior border gives origin of the flexodigitorum superficialis muscle, and from the anterior surface, there is origin of the flexor pollicis longus muscle. The posterior surface, there is origin of the extensor pollicis brevis. Above the extensor pollicis brevis, there is abductor pollicis longus muscle is originated. These are the attachment of the radius. Joint produced by the radius. The upper end of the radius and ulna articulate with the radius articulate with capitulum of the humerus and trochlea articulate with the trochlea of the humerus forms the elbow joint. The upper end of the radius and ulna articulate each other form the superior radioulnar joint and lower end of the radius and ulna articulate each other form the inferior radioulnar joint. The interosseous border of the radius and ulna articulate each other by interosseous membrane form the medial radioulnar joint. The lower end of the radius and ulna, the lower end articulate with the scaphoid bone and lunate form the wrist joint. Ulna takes part in the formation of the wrist joint by the collateral ligament of the wrist joint. These are the joints produced by the radius. Clinical anatomy. The radius commonly gets fracture about 2 cm above its lower end called Colles fracture. It is caused by fall on the outstretched hand. The distal fragment is displaced upwards and backwards and radial styloid process comes to lie proximal to the ulnar styloid process. Normally, it lies distally. The picture shows the Colles fracture. This X-ray shows the fracture on the lower end of the radius. Ulna. The ulna is the medial bone of the forearm and is homologous with the fibula of the lower limb. Anatomical point of the ulna is the upper end. There is hook-like projection and its concavity directed forwards. The lateral border of the ulna is sharp and crest-like. Pointed styloid process lies medial to the rounded head of the ulna. Parts. It has upper end shaped and lower end. The upper end presents the olecranon and coronoid processes, trochlear notch, and radial notch. Trochlear knots articulate with the trochlea of humerus, forms the elbow joint. Radial knots articulate with the head of the radius, form the superior radial knot joint. The shaft has three borders and three surfaces. Borders are interosseous or lateral border. This is the interosseous or lateral border. Anterior border extends from medial side of the ulnar tuberosity to the medial side of the styloid process. Posterior border, it extends from back of the olecranon process to the base of the styloid process. Surfaces, there are three surfaces. Anterior surface lies between the anterior and interosseous border. Medial surface lies between the anterior and posterior border. Posterior surface lies between the posterior and interosseous border. It is subdivided into three area by two lines. An oblique line divides it into upper and lower parts. The lower part further divided by a vertical line into medial and lateral area. Lower end presents head and styloid process. This is the head of the ulna and this is styloid process. Styloid process projects downwards from the posteromedial side of the lower end of the ulna. Attachment of the ulna is the posterior part of the superior surface of olecranon process. Here triceps muscle is inserted. Below the triceps, there is anconeus is inserted. At the supinator crest, the supinator muscle is originated. And from the lateral surface, there is origin of the abductor pollicis longus, extensor pollicis longus, and extensor indicis. These muscles are originated from the posterior surface. And anterior surface, at the upper part, there is origin of the flexor digitorum profundus. And from the anterior lower part of the anterior border, there is pronator quadratus muscle is originated, and medial margin of the coronoid process of ulna, here flexor digitorum superficialis and pronator teres muscle are originated. The joint produced by the ulna are the upper end of the ulna articulate with the trochlea of the humerus, and olecranon process articulate with the olecranon fossa of the humerus, form the elbow joint. And ulna articulate with the radius, form the superior radial ulnar joint. The lower end of the ulna articulate with the lower end of the radius, form the inferior radial ulnar joint. And interosseous border between two bone are articulate each other by interosseous membrane, form the medial radial ulnar joint. The ulna takes part in the formation of the wrist joint by collateral ligament, ulnar collateral ligament of the wrist joint. The elbow joint is hinge variety of synovial joint. It causes flexion and extension. Superior radial ulnar joint is pivot variety of synovial joint. Medial radial ulnar joint is syndesmosis variety of fibrous joint. Inferior radial ulnar joint also pivot variety of synovial joint. The radial ulnar joint superior inferior are produced supination and pronation movement. The wrist joint, it is ellipsoid variety of synovial joint. It causes flexion, extension, adduction and abduction. According to axis, it is biaxial joint. And according to axis, elbow joint is uniaxial joint. Articulated skeleton of hand. It presents three types of bone. These are the carpal bone, these are the metacarpal bone, and these are the phalanges. The carpal bone lies in two row, the proximal row from lateral to medial side. This is capoid, lunate, triquetral and pisiform. And from distal row, there is trapezium, trapezoid, capitate and hamate. Hamate presents a hook. There are five metatarsal bone. The first metatarsal is shortest, thickest, and strongest. There are 5 metatarsal bone. The first metatarsal is shortest, thickest, and strongest from all metatarsal. Thumb contain 2 phalanges and other finger contain 3 phalanges. Total phalanges are 14 in number. These are the first carpometacarpal joint. It is saddle variety of synovial joint. Rest of the carpometacarpal joint are plain variety of synovial joint. Here intercarpal joint all are the plain variety of synovial joint. This is the metacarpophalangeal joint. It is ellipsoid variety of synovial joint. This is the interphalangeal joint. It is hinge variety of synovial joint. This is all about the bones of the superior extremity. Here are some class assignment which you have to solve in your vacation period and after when your college will be open, and you submitted this assignment in your respective past teachers. The questions are from my previous lecture, thorax card. Draw and label the intercostal space. Draw and label bronchial tree, bronchopulmonary segment. Draw and label relation on the mediastinal surface of both lung. Draw and label interior of the right atrium. Draw and label blood supply of the heart. From today's lecture, superior extremity card. Write down the origin, insertion, nerve supply, and action of following muscles: deltoid, trapezius, bicep brachii, triceps brachii, brachialis, brachioradialis, flexor digitorum superficialis, flexor digitorum profundus, pronator teres, pronator quadratus, pectoralis major. Another question is, why clavicle is called modified long bone? Short note on wrist drop, claw hand, carpal tunnel syndrome. You have to practice draw and label brachial plexus. Thank you all. Stay home, stay safe. Have faith on Allah. May Almighty Allah protect all of us. Allah Hafiz.